Viper.
Boy.
Tempest in the sea, your love is like a storm. Oh,
everybody. So I know you guys are enjoying the pizza and fun out in the foyer. I love it so much. But we're going to go ahead and get started with our Freedom Church worship night. And I want to take a second. I see my husband walking off over there. But for those of you that might be guests with us tonight, we want to introduce ourselves. Yeah, there we go. Go ahead, babe.
Good evening, guys. Thank you for coming out. My name is Joe. I'm the pastor of Freedom Church, and we love worship here, and so I think we're going to enjoy this night. Thank you for coming out.
Yes, and we also want to welcome our live stream family. We've got a whole bunch of people in Oklahoma.
Hi, Mom.
Ohio, different places. His mom, exactly. Hi, Linda. Love you. That watch us online, and they're just as much a part of our family as you are, so... I also want to say, I know, I'm not sure if the kids are going to be in here for partially part of the worship, but if the kids aren't here, parents, just know, if you want your kids with you when you worship, you're welcome to do that. If you'd rather them stay with their group of kids, that's also, we're prepared for that. But then I also want you all to know this, that tonight is between you and God. It's not a concert. It's different because this time that we have just focusing on the Lord, singing praises and thanksgiving for everything he's done, it's about you and the Lord. It's about your relationship. It's about you taking time to just say, I love you. It's about letting him pour out his love on you. So if that can happen better for you in one of the corners of the room or kneeling or coming up here and kneeling on the altar, or at your seat sitting there, again, God's looking at your heart. And I just want you to be free to worship him, the Bible says, in spirit and in truth. If you want to come up here, even some of the kids, if you want to come up here and dance with us, we love that too, because we like to have fun here at Freedom. So are you guys ready to worship God with us? Amen. Well, we're just going to kick it off tonight in celebration.
Open the way. The day you gave.
There's freedom in the name. There's power in the name. There's healing in the name of Jesus. Come on, sing it. There's freedom in the name. There's power in the name. There's healing.
There's power in the name.
change everything. Jesus, you change everything. Oh.
Everything in you to get here tonight. You felt like the whole world was coming down on you, and like everything was a struggle, like nothing seemed to be going right. But because you stepped out, and because God loves you, and because He's a good God, you're going to notice when you walk out of this place, everything has changed. Everything is going to be different. Those burdens that were laying on top of you have been lifted. That fear, that anxiety, those things that were just pounding your mind, that lack of clarity, it's going to be clear. It's time. Jesus has already set you free. So press in, press in, press in, press in. Because as you press in, He's going to meet you. As you seek Him, you will find Him. Nothing is going to be the same when you walk out of these doors. Mark this day on your calendar, because as you step out, you are going to notice a difference. You are going to see things differently. You are going to think about things differently. And you're going to wake up tomorrow morning and know God has shown up for you. You have found His love. You have found His freedom. So start rejoicing, because it's done.
Say we've had church, you know what I'm saying? So what we're going to do right now, and I want to say for all our precious kids that are in here right now, if you want to follow Jeannie back to your, there's Jeannie right there, and you're going to go back and have fun and do something special for your moms even. I won't tell the secret, but so you guys are dismissed at this point. And then the other thing I'd like to do is, any graduates in here tonight, at all, from any kind of college training, whatever it might be, I'd like all the graduates to come up here this morning, or this evening. We want to pray over you. We want to bless you. We just want to speak into your life. I know a lot of times it's like a brand new chapter. Yeah, we can give the graduates a hand. Come on. Any graduates, come on up here or down here. I know we've got some graduates on the stage. But I'd like to encourage those of you that know these amazing people, if you'd like to just come up and pray and agree with them, or just encourage them, give them a word, or whatever it is, if you just want to pray over them, speak a blessing. But I'm telling you what, God is so, He's a proud daddy tonight. He's a proud daddy, because I believe that whatever training it's been, whatever that God instructed you to do, and you stepped out in obedience and you were like, yeah, I'm going to do this. And it might be scary, and it might be hard, and it might, you know, have been challenging. There might have been times, how many of you up here right now would say there were times you wanted to quit? Any of you wanted to quit? I know. Yeah, 500 times. Me too. So, I want to just pray over each one of you. And as I'm praying, if you guys just want to come on in here and just start to speak over them, Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for every single one of your children here tonight that took a step in faith, stepped out into the waters, out of their comfort zone, out of what was familiar and easy, and trusted in you. And Father, I thank you for the grace that you poured out on their lives to sustain them, to keep them on the path. You've kept them, your keeping power. And I thank you for doing that. And Father, you kept them for something so awesome. I thank you that you make it clear to them from this day forward what the next step is. Do they stay? Do they go? Do they take this job or that job? I thank you. You make it so clear to them that they follow peace in their heart, because you said the steps of the righteous are ordered. So, Father, as you're ordaining and ordering those steps, I thank you. They see you and they hear you. And they won't miss it. But they'll stay right on course, right in your timing. Father, just walking in your wisdom, your blessing, and your grace. Thank you, Father. So I want to say something to the graduates as well as people are praying. I just heard the Lord say this. And those of you that, I'm going to wait a minute because I want you guys, I don't want you to miss what someone's praying over you right now. Thank you, Father. Okay, so as soon as you guys are done praying over your graduate, I'd like all the graduates to turn around and just face me for just a moment. Because I know that the Lord has something also that he put on my heart while I was just up here praying for you. And thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. So you guys stepped out in God's strength and ability to go through all that training, the classes, the time, whether it was 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, 5 years, whatever it's been. And how many of you could raise your hand and say, man, I had to draw from his grace. I would have quit, I would have failed if it was not for him, amen? So what I heard him say when I was praying for you is, don't now that you're graduating decide you're gonna take matters into your own hands. It's so tempting. You know, you're out of school, and you feel like, hey, you know, I've got this certificate, I've got this title, I've got this training, I'm prepared. And so I got this. I believe I heard the Lord say, now more than ever, you need to be listening. You need to make sure that you're stepping right into what he's saying. And some things might even look good, but are they God? Is it God? Because he didn't bring you this far for you to crash and burn. So listen. Listen to his timing. Listen to his placement. Listen to the people, the friendships, the jobs. Listen to him. He's not going to steer you wrong. He's going to lead you beside still waters in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. You're a carrier of his name, and you're going to carry his name into that next chapter, that next place, and you're going to be mighty men and women of God for his glory. Amen? Amen. Well, can we give them all just an amazing hand? Woo! All right, you guys can be seated. God bless you. Oh, man. So beautiful. So awesome. We are just so blessed to do life with all of you. We really are. This is a joy for Pastor Joe and I to just partner with all of you in life. I know some of you are first-time guests with us tonight, but hey, you're part of the family of God, so you're still in the family. But we just want you to know you're loved. You are loved by God. You're loved by your brothers and sisters. And I'm so thankful for Freedom Church and what God's doing. He said, I will build my church. Even Pastor Joe and I know that too, that we couldn't take matters into our own hands and do this, only God. So you guys want to sing a little bit more and rejoice before we... I know, me too, amen? You're probably going to want to stand for this. I'm just saying you don't have to, but try sitting down, okay?
I raise a hallelujah.
I don't know what your storm is. I don't know what the battle is. I don't know what unbelief you're dealing with. I don't know what the battle is. But I'll tell you two people that do. God knows it, and your enemy knows it. But God has given us a weapon. It's His words coming out of our mouths. Our faith is voice activated. Did you know that? So what we're going to do on the count of three, you, in your own words, are going to be able to shout praises to God, or say praises, or sing praises. I don't know what you want to do or say, but it's between you and God, and it's you letting the enemy know he is defeated. He has lost his fight over your life. You don't belong to the devil. You belong to Jesus, for you've been bought with his blood. He's called you by declare who you are. You declare who you belong to. great are you, Lord. So I want to take just a moment, because we don't get to meet with you guys tomorrow morning for Mother's Day, but so it's going to, now I'm asking you guys to sit. That's hilarious. So first I'm like, go ahead and sit, try sit. But for the moms, so we know how many moms and who the moms are, because we have a gift for you that we want to give you tonight. So if all my moms in here could stand up nice, big, and strong, and confident. Come on, moms. We love our mamas, don't we? Woo, all the mamas. We've got a gift for you. Are we passing them? Yeah, we've got right here, we've got chocolate. Of course, us mamas, we need chocolate, right? And a rose, just to say that you're beautiful, and we love you, and we appreciate you, and we honor you as mothers in this place. And can I just say something right now? That doesn't just, a mama is not just a person who has physically bore a child, because I've never physically had a child, but I have lots of babies. So I also want to say, if you're a spiritual mom in here, or if you're a mentor to a lot of youngers, I want you to stand up too. Thank you. Any other moms in here that would say, hey, I got lots of baby girls and boys, but maybe I didn't bear them myself. Yeah, make sure all those mamas get a flower too and a chocolate, because we honor you. Amen. And let me just pray a blessing over all the moms in here. Father, I thank you. First of all, even for the moms all around the world, man, we're so grateful. Thank you, Father, that you ordained life. Yeah, and even in this day and age, when so many mamas are being told that that child is not a real life, Father, strengthen all the moms that are pregnant right now, that are being tempted or lied to about giving that baby away or taking its life. Send people right now. I'm speaking, I know, to mamas, maybe even listening on live stream, I don't know. But that baby has a destiny. God's already named that child in your womb. And I thank you for giving them the courage, the grace, and people to surround those mamas to follow through to full-term pregnancy and give birth to that life in the name of Jesus. We thank you for that, Father. And then to all those that have maybe lost a baby at some point, what, through miscarriage or death, an accident, whatever, I speak healing to every broken mama's heart right now. Healing and wholeness and restoration. And to all the mamas out there that have desired to have babies, and they struggled and they can't seem to get pregnant, Father, I ask you right now by the Holy Spirit to breathe life into their womb. Jesus, the great physician, fix everything that's wrong right now so they can bear the life that they desire and be the mother and father that they will desire, Father, that you've placed that dream in them. I speak wholeness to that mother's womb and that father's body so they can bear children. And then to every mama in this room, I ask you to bless, strengthen them, continue to show them their worth and their value in Christ. We honor the mothers who've given life and raised and discipled and taught, disciplined. We thank you for all of it, Lord, for our moms. In Jesus' name, can we all say amen? We love you, moms.
Woo. And we also want to take a moment while you guys are seated so nicely. We just want to take a moment, and this is a worship night, and another form of worship is to give your tithes and offerings. And so we want to give you an opportunity to do that. And I say this all the time, what your purpose in your heart, what the Lord's showing you, just take a moment and say, Lord, am I to give something tonight? And what is it? Can I give it happily? And then I believe that that's going to bless you. So let's just take a moment. Lord, I just thank you. If you need a offering envelope or something like that, we have our ushers have those. There's ways to give, and they should also be on the seats around you. And so we're just going to take a moment to do that. And so, Lord, we thank you and we love you. I thank you for this opportunity to just worship you with the body of Christ, to worship you with each other tonight. And I thank you, Lord, that you're here, that you are just present. You're ready to do everything that needs done. And I thank you, Lord, for just blessing everyone who's come tonight. And we love you. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. And after the bucket goes by, you can stand with us for one last song. We're going to take it out just with celebration of our God and his holiness and his power in our lives. So you're welcome to stand with us after that bucket goes by.
Jesus is in.
Swing wide, I see glory as I run inside the throne room.
good to us. And we thank you, Father, that because of Jesus, we could stand before you in the most holy of holy place, knowing that you've made us now your temple. And you live and dwell inside of us, and we honor, we reverence, and we praise and offer thanksgiving for who you are. Such a good Father, a Savior, the one that will leave the 99 to go find the one. The purest love, that's who you are, Lord. And we honor you tonight with our praises, with our time, our hands, and our song. And here's our hearts, Lord. They are yours. Close a service without giving anyone an opportunity in here that maybe he's never called on the name of Jesus, and you're saying, I don't even know what I just experienced, but I know it's real, and I know he's alive, and I want to know him. Is there anyone in here that would just respond with raising your hand and saying, I want to respond to Jesus for the first time in my life and receive him as my Lord and Savior? Is there anyone in here where you just want to right now, because you can't hardly stand it, your heart's beating and you're like, I just want to know him? Anyone at all in here? All right, so if my prayer team could come up here tonight, and so if there's anything you need prayer for, we want to make our prayer team available to you. Maybe you've given your heart back to Christ tonight. Maybe you've experienced a healing and you just want to testify and tell someone about it. Or if there's a relative or a friend or something that, man, you just have on your heart that you need agreement prayer with, whatever it may be, healing for your body. But just know we love you and we're here to pray for you and agree with you about anything. And so I just want to speak a blessing over all of you before we dismiss tonight. And Father, I do thank you, for you are good and your mercies endure forever. Great is your faithfulness over each and every one of your children. I thank you that tonight each one of us will have sweet, peaceful sleep, wake up in the morning refreshed, full of strength and joy for the journey. I speak joy, a restoration of joy over each one of you and in your hearts and lives and marriages and jobs. In Jesus' name, can we all say amen together? Amen. God bless you all. We'll see you next week. We love you.